Hi, and welcome back to the channel. Well, as you probably know, Hover did a new update this week for the Pro and the ProMax. Now, in addition to the new spiraling mode on the Pro and the ProMax, you've also got an additional distance with orbit of 10 meters and the ability to use the, what's it called? I can't think of the name of it. Copilot, that's it. And the ability to use Copilot with all of the modes. Plus on the display at the on the drone itself, it shows you the available battery life. Sorry, not battery life. It shows you the available disk space that you've got. Now, one of the things it also brought out was for the beacon. And this allows you now for the beacon to record the stats of the ride or the run, whatever you're doing, and then overlay them on top of your footage. So you've got a record of the distance, the speed, etc. for your workout. So first of all, I'll show you how to get that set up on the beacon and then how it works. Also at the end of this, I'll give you a quick rundown on the spiral mode just to explain quickly how it works. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to make sure that the drone and the beacon are connected. Once they are, you just need to swipe down from the top, go over to beacon, and then scroll up until you see dashboard. Click on that, switch it on, and that's it. Just swipe back over, turn it off, and now the beacon will send all the information directly to the drone for you to overlay when you export. Okay, as you know, I'm not sponsored, so if you find this useful, give us the subscribe, thumbs up and like, as it does help out, as everybody says on every single video that you watch. So when you're ready then, you just go into your photo album, select the clip that you want to download, and on the bottom you can see that it's got a dashboard. So you can select that, and then the file will download. Now you've got six different bits of information. You've got the date, the duration of your ride or run, the distance that you've gone, the altitude you're at, the speed that you have gone at that particular time, and also a copy of the route that you've taken, so you can see exactly where you've gone. So far, I can't see any way that you can change and select these options, so you have to be stuck with what they've actually got. Okay, and as I said at the beginning, I'll give you a quick rundown now on the new spiral mode. So you set, So you set the distance that you wanted to go. The drone will go around clockwise, and as it'll go around, it'll start to ascend. Once it's done one complete revolution, then it starts to descend back until it comes back to the front of you. So it's quite simple, more or less the same as orbit, but obviously you've got the added ascent as it goes around. Okay, that's done. If you did find it useful, give us the thumbs up, as I said earlier, the like, the bell, and all that gubbins. It would be interesting to know if you've got any questions or how you're using it. Just drop me some comments below, and I'll catch you again next time. Thanks very much. Bye.